Hello viewers, welcome to EduAid. So in our previous session, we have discussed about dispersion of white light by a glass prism. In this session, we are going to discuss about atmospheric refraction. Now viewers, what is atmospheric refraction? Refraction of light caused by the Earth's atmosphere is called atmospheric refraction. Now the question is, how is refraction of light caused by this Earth's atmosphere? The answer is, you see that in our Earth's atmosphere, there is air everywhere. But not all the air in our Earth's atmosphere is at the same temperature. Some of the layers of air are hot and some of the layers of air are cold. Now these hotter layers serve as the optically rarer medium. Why? Because in these hotter layers, the air molecules are very loosely bounded with each other. Okay, so they serve as the optically rarer medium. And this cooler layer serve as the optically denser medium. Why? Because you see, in the cooler layers, the air molecules are very tightly bounded with each other. And they serve as the optically denser medium. Now what happens is that when light from a luminous body or from a non-luminous body enters the Earth's atmosphere, it undergoes refraction from these different layers of this Earth's atmosphere. And this refraction caused by this Earth's atmosphere is called atmospheric refraction. So we can say that in our Earth's atmosphere, there are different layers of air. Some layers of air are hot and some layers of air are cold. Now these hotter layers serve as the optically rarer medium, so we can say that the refractive index of those layers are less. And these cooler layers serve as the optically denser medium, so we can say that the refractive index of those layers are more. Okay. Now refraction of light caused by these layers is called atmospheric refraction. Now let us try to see one example. So here you can see that this is a fire and there is an object behind the fire. Now if you try to look at the object through these layers of airs over the fire, you will see that this object appears to slightly move. Why? Because you see that this layer which is just above fire is a very hot layer. So we can say that it is an optically rarer medium. And the layer which is just above this layer is an optically denser medium because it is cooler than the layer which is just below it. So when light ray from the object comes through these layers and it enters our eyes, it undergoes refraction from these different layers. And that is why this object appears to slightly move. Okay. Now, there are different events which are associated with atmospheric refraction. Now, the first event which is associated with atmospheric refraction is the twinkling of the stars. And the second event which is associated with this atmospheric refraction is the advanced sunrise and the delayed sunset. Let us study each of them individually now. So, the first event which is associated with atmospheric refraction is the twinkling of the stars. Viewers, when you look at the stars on a clear night sky, you observe that the stars appear bright for some time and after some time it appears dim. And this process keeps on repeating. So this process of the stars getting bright for some time and after some time getting dim is called as the twinkling of the stars. Now viewers, you see, this twinkling of the stars is related to this atmospheric refraction. This twinkling of the stars is caused because of atmospheric refraction of stars light. So what happens is that when light from the star enters the Earth's atmosphere, it undergoes refraction from the various layers of this Earth atmosphere. Okay. Now this Earth's atmosphere is continuously changing, and this continuously changing Earth's atmosphere refracts the starlight at different amounts in different moments of time. Okay. So if this Earth's atmosphere refracts more starlight towards us, then the star appear brighter. And if this Earth's atmosphere refracts less starlight towards us, then the stars appear dim, and this combined process is called as the twinkling of the stars. So we can say that light from the star, when it enters the Earth's atmosphere, it undergoes refraction from the various layers of this Earth's atmosphere. And if this Earth's atmosphere refracts more starlight towards our eyes, then the stars appear brighter. And if this Earth's atmosphere refracts less starlight towards our eyes, then the stars appear dim. And this combined process is called as the twinkling of the stars. Now you see that the stars twinkle, but the planets do not twinkle. Why? Because you see that the stars are located at a very far away distance from us as compared to that of the planets. So we can consider the stars to be point sources of light. And a planet we can consider to be a collection of point sources of light. So the dimming effect which is produced by some of the point sources of light is nullified by the brighter effect which is produced by the other point sources of light. So as a whole, we can say that the brightness of the planet remains the same and this planet do not appear to twinkle. Okay. Now, another important thing to be noted down about stars is that the apparent position of the star is at a relatively higher position as compared to the original position of the star. Let us try to understand how it happens. So this is an observer who is standing on the Earth's surface, and here is the Earth's atmosphere. Now one thing important to be noted down about this Earth's atmosphere. As you go from top to bottom, the optical densities keeps on increasing. So this is the original position of the star. And when the starlight enters the Earth's atmosphere, it undergoes refraction from the various layers of this Earth's atmosphere. And as a result of which, it follows a curved path before reaching the observer's eyes. And you see that the starlight, when it enters the Earth's atmosphere, and as it goes further down and down, the refraction occurs more and more. Now, if you backtrace this refracted rays, you can see that the virtual image of the star is formed, which is above the original position of the star. And a new position of the star is called as the apparent position of the star. Now, as you can see that the apparent position of the star is at a relatively higher position as compared to that of the original position of the star. So this is another important thing to be noted down about stars. That is, the apparent position of the star is at a relatively higher position as compared to the original position of the star. So this is all about the first event which is associated with atmospheric refraction. That is the twinkling of the stars. Okay. Now viewers, let us discuss the second event which is associated with atmospheric refraction. It is the advanced sunrise and the delayed sunset. Viewers, sunrise is advanced because of atmospheric refraction of sunlight, and sunset is delayed because of atmospheric refraction of sunlight. Let us try to understand how it happens. So let us consider this one as the Earth's surface, and here is the Earth's atmosphere. Now one thing important to be noted down about this Earth's atmosphere, as I've said earlier, that as you move from top to bottom, the optical densities of the Earth's atmosphere keeps on increasing. Now, we know that the line of horizon is a tangent to the Earth's surface. So here is a line of horizon. Okay. Now, let us consider one observer who is standing on the Earth's surface. So here is the observer. Now, at the time of sunrise, what happens is that the sun is actually below the horizon. It has not risen yet, and it is about to rise. So here is the position of the sun, which is below the horizon. Now at that time, what happens is that sunlight falls at the Earth's atmosphere at an oblique angle, and then it enters the Earth's atmosphere. Now it undergoes refraction from the different layers of the Earth's atmosphere before reaching the observer's eyes. Now you see that the path which is taken by sunlight to the observer's eyes is a curved path. Okay. Again, another thing you see that as the sunlight enters the Earth's atmosphere and as it moves further down, the refraction occurs more and more. Now, if you backtrace this refracted rays, you can see that the virtual image of the sun is formed somewhere here, which is above the horizon. Okay. So this is the apparent position of the sun, and this position of the sun is visible to this observer. The original position of the sun is not visible to this observer. And you see that sunrise is advanced because of atmospheric refraction of light. Now, the time difference between the apparent position of the sun and the original position of the sun is approximately 2 minutes. Similarly, at the time of sunset, what happens is that the sun has already set. That means it has moved already below the horizon. So this is the original position of the sun. But for this observer, the apparent position of the sun is visible, and which is above the horizon. Okay. Now you see here also that the time difference between the apparent position of the sun and the original position of the sun also here is approximately 2 minutes. So this is all about the advanced sunrise and the delayed sunset. Sunrise is advanced and sunset is delayed because of atmospheric refraction of sunlight. And this is all about this session, where you have studied about atmospheric refraction and the events which are associated with atmospheric refraction. In our upcoming session, we are going to discuss about scattering of light. Thank you.